Welcome everyone. So I wanted to do another use case video, and this other use case that I have is in regards to government contracting. So government contracts is something that I'm very familiar with. I'm very familiar with the process of how governments pay contractors, whether that be subcontractors or prime contractors. So depending on what organization that you're working with, if you're working with the Department of Defense, or you're working with the USDA, or you're working with the EPA, if you win a contract with these particular organizations, first of all, it's a very convoluted process, but the payment structure, it's usually like a net 30. So you have a portal and you basically invoice the government and they have 30 days to pay you from that particular time. And this is very difficult for small businesses. So, you know, they usually go and get some small business administration loans or third party loans that are usually have some sort of interest tacked onto them, you know, whether that's a few percentage points all the way to like 10, 20%. It depends on how lucrative the contract is and how much money you want for that particular contract. But it's usually a whole thing about that whole credit dilemma. You know, it's hard to get a government contract unless you're ready to really put your foot out there. But if you're ready to put your foot out there, you may not have what it takes to actually put your foot out there. So it's sometimes a leap for a lot of these small businesses. And the thing is, waiting that 30-day period, it really ties up the liquidity. So your business is really a one-faceted business. It's like you're just focused on government contracts. You really can't spread your money elsewhere until you get paid in that next cycle, and the process repeats itself. Over the years, you may get added liquidity, and that's going to allow you to expand your business, but it takes a while. I was thinking about smart contracts in the use case of allowing contracts to be broken down into pieces. So say you are doing a certain contract, an aviation contract or a janitorial contract for an organization. So you're cleaning the buildings and, you know, you're getting your supplies, you have your workers cleaning one floor and another floor, or however you're structuring the contract, and, you know, the contract is probably for a year. And instead of billing the company or billing the government organization every month, if the billing was more automatic and you could set some kind of timetable, okay, the floors were cleaned today, or this was cleaned, this was the percentage done is this, you know, I accomplished 20% of the task given to me today. And you could put that on the blockchain and you can automatically get those funds distributed in smaller pieces, it would allow for increased liquidity from both sides. So the government wouldn't have to give you this lump sum after 30 days after the completion of the contract. They could give you little small pieces, and the small business could receive those little small pieces and correctly fund their workers without taking these high interest predatory loans, and they can use that to fund their business, and they could use that to expand their business. There's so many different ways in which that added liquidity could allow businesses to grow. I mean, there's such a constraint for small businesses to grow. It's hard, it's difficult, because there's so much to take that next step to get to the next level. You really need, not only do you need your foot in the door, but you need to be able to have that cash flow growing. And, you know, like, I sometimes think that it's a giant collusion scheme, because the government is doing that. They want you to take those high interest loans, and then you have to go to the bank, open up a line of credit, and the banks love to give you a hard time with line of credit. You could say that you have a contract for X amount of dollars and show the contract to the bank, and they're still giving you X minus 10, whatever you're asking for. They're always giving you a hard time, always giving you less line of credit than you need, even if you have the contract in front of you. It's like, you need to prove yourself. Well, how do I prove myself if I can't take that step forward? And this is where smart contracts can take us to the next level. Revolutionizing small business. You saw it on Marlo. It's supposed to be for the institutions, the mom and pops, and I think it was called Businesses and Sons. It's for those small businesses to really increase their liquidity, really increase what they can do, their capabilities. this country is run on small and medium enterprises, and you know, of course, we have the behemoth enterprises, but if we're really trying to promote a healthy economy, if we're really saying that we're all about small business, we're all about this, I don't know, American dream, the idea that someone can build their business and, you know, support their family, it's not necessarily about turning it into a large enterprise, but just support themselves, you know, and, you know, taking a high interest 20% loan to get your first contract and taking 20% out of your family's mouth when you are really trying to make it, it's not the right way to go. So, you know, I think that smart contracts could allow for more accountability. It could make this, if you put the contract on the blockchain and you provide these timetables, okay, this deliverable was met, you get an automatic small payment for this. You get an automatic small payment for this. You get an automatic small payment for this. You know, I've just purchased janitorial supplies. This fits this quota, and you piece it, and then, you know, money gets transferred. And I think that could be, that would be great. That would be great. And this could happen in the fiat system. And, you know, that doesn't necessarily mean that people have to be transacting ADA. But in the future, ADA is going to have a lot of use cases or benefits to actually holding ADA. You know, you're going to probably be able to stake your ADA at the exact same time that you're performing this contract, which will allow you to actually reverse this entire process. So instead of getting a high interest loan, maybe safeguarding your money in a way that will provide you interest over time. So it will allow your small business to grow, and you can tap into that liquidity pool whenever and interoperate between that native cryptocurrency and your general fiat system. So if you need the dollars real quick, you can get into that, or you need euros real quick, or you can get into that. It's quick, and I think that this is where we're going. I think this is where we're going. We're going towards this ultimate interoperable cryptocurrency. And there are a lot of cryptocurrencies out there. It's not going to be a winner takes all, but there are huge advantages to Cardano and their smart contracting platform. I'm very excited. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you have any use cases of your own. And, you know, until the next video, please like, comment, subscribe, and I appreciate it. I appreciate you.